his head's moving way, way faster than me. So like trying to do it based on him is looking at the fiducial.
Alright, so what if we don't prove it? So once he finds the fiducial, angle it up, he pivots until he sees the fiducial. When he sees it again, he should be lined up relatively with the ball on the fiducial. So he looks down, checks for the ball at that point. Then, if he sees the ball in front of him, he should be able to get up close enough to it to kick it. Because I don't think you're ever going to be able to see the fiducial on the ball in the second frame. You're going to have to move his head up.
The problem is, that basically is what we're doing right now. But I've stopped the fiducial. I'm not looking for the fiducial, though. When he finds the fiducial in his head, and what you're saying is what I'm doing, I'm not continually making him look for the fiducial.
So why,
the problem
why is his head moving though while he's pivoting? That's why I don't understand. He should just be able to leave his head alone. And when it comes into frame.
Well, that's what I'm saying. But that is pivoting his head. What you're saying is, it looks like his head's staying still, but he really is. It just happens that his head and body are moving at the same rate.
So how are you getting him to pivot? Are you using set position, or are you actually using that beta parameter in the set long ball?
I'm getting a set velocity. So I mean, it's just his head moves like way too fast is where the problem is. Like his head catches up too fast to his body, so he stops immediately.